SSP have taken cognizance of the SFI report because it has been presented to the government on the 13th. Connivance of the statutory auditor, that is what the SFI report says. It's pretty damning, the sort of evidence that the SFI report suggests with regards to Pricewaterhouse. To your mind now, what really happens as far as Pricewaterhouse is concerned?
Yeah, well, see, it has two aspects, basically. You know, if we have to look at the milder sort of aspect, their CFO, you know, Srinivas, if I remember his name correctly, had made a statement before the investigating agency that we had submitted forged documents to the auditors, meaning thereby that auditors are not at fault. It's actually we, the management, which is at fault. But then, yes, they were not supposed to believe those documents as gospel truth. It was their duty.
If I can just interject there, Hemant, the report actually says that Pricewaterhouse had observed deficiencies in Satyam's system audit, but it kept silent. It also goes on to say that they did not follow auditing and assurance standard 15, and that they you know, this went on for over 8 years, and it's really surprising that the auditor would not notice. And they actually have specified that they did observe deficiencies in the system, but kept silent about it.
Yeah, well, if that is the case, then there is one section which directly deals with misconduct on the part of auditors. There is just a penalty of about 10,000 rupees. But yes, if one has to look at general sections like 628 and 630, they provide that if anybody is involved in falsification of accounts or concealment of the right figures, in that case, they could be imprisoned for 2 years. That is under the Companies Act. So therefore, this again is a milder. But if you were to talk about Section 477 under the Indian Penal Code, if they were to be prosecuted for falsification of accounts or abetment, for that matter, let me tell you, they would not only lose their license, but they could actually be behind bars for a period of up to 7 years. So yes, I think they would be key accused, not witnesses. They would be key accused as and when SFIO decides to file a criminal complaint or lodges an FIR. And these are all offences where they would be arrested immediately, and getting bail would be difficult for them. So I'm confident that as it is a financial fraud, they would be key accused, and they would be prosecuted. And if they are prosecuted under Indian Penal Code, I think that would be more viable,
right,
feasible, and stricter sort of cause of action,
okay,
rather than under the Companies Act, because that's sure. I think is not sufficient. Yeah.